بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Respected brothers and sisters, during these unprecedented times, we've realized the need of so many destitute people, so many communities that have been left deprived for so many years, the need for people to have their hardships lifted and their necessities granted to them, from food and drink, essential supplies and clothing also. The need of charities for the generosity of their donors. During this time where we are under lockdown and where many of us may be struggling, I remind you of the virtue of charity. I remind you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, the likeness of those who give in the cause of Allah is like an ear, is like a grain that grows 7 ears. In each ear there are 100 grains, and Allah multiplies for whomever He wills. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiplies the reward of charity. Not only does He multiply the reward, but He multiplies the wealth itself. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has said in the Hadith Qudusi, give, O son of Adam, and I shall give you. And Allah says, and there is not of a charity that you give, except that we will immediately compensate you. This is a promise from Allah, one that we cannot doubt the truth of. Because the one who doubts it believes in the promise of the wretched shaitan, may he be cursed, who says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us of him, الشَّيْطَانُ يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرِ. Shaytan promises you poverty and commands you to perform evil deeds. وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ مَغْفِرَةً مِّنْهُ وَفَضْلًا. And Allah promises you forgiveness from Him and bounty. The bounty is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Know that if you give, your money will be blessed and it will not reduce. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he swore by Allah that no wealth will decrease from charity. We must believe Allah and His Messenger. The charities and mosques and Islamic institutions which have their donation streams running dry at the moment are in dire need. Are in dire need not for them to put on grand events, but for their very survival, for them to be able to continue during this crisis and after this crisis. I implore my brothers and my sisters to give generously, and to not fear poverty. A man came to Umar radiallahu anh, complaining of poverty. Umar radiallahu anh advised him and said to him to give charity. He knew with certainty that if you give for the sake of Allah, Allah will multiply your money and grant you blessing in that money that would not have been granted had you not given in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So do not fear. Do not fear poverty, for that is from the shaitan. Do not fear your wealth diminishing, for it shall not diminish. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He grants us. Nobody grants us. No furloughing, no benefit, no uncle, no relative. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the provider. All you must do is fear Him and be conscious of Him, and He will give you from sources you never could have imagined. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And he who fears Allah, Allah grants for him a way out and grant and blesses him and provides him from sources he never could have thought of. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us during this pandemic, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to preserve our health and to preserve our families and to preserve our wealth and to bless it through charity. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to extend our lives to observe the month of Ramadan, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins and elevate our station and admit us into His gardens. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.